Okay, first I want to give thanks and praise to the Most High. Earlier on, we had the great man Ricardo inside the house. I'm talking about the great man Muhammad Ali. And inside the hot seat, we do have Josie. Yeah. Josie, how you coming, brother? You good?
Yeah, I'm good.
Nice one. Good to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, and Josie will be talking about the kind of stuff he's been doing. He's an educational financial. He educates people, family about their, educating family about finance. Is that right, say so? Yeah. So, listen. Just a little about yourself, man. How you got anything about finance and etc.? How'd that come about? Yeah.
Well, I mean, I've got a long story. Because first of all, I want to be a pilot. And then when I failed the eye test those days, there was no correction. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, I went to university and came to England to study finance and management.
Okay.
And then I started working for a bank as an auditor. And then I found out that working in a bank, you don't have much flexibility to help people who actually need it. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a kind of a tick box. So then I became a financial consultant. Mm. And right now what I do is that I help people actually manage their finance.
Okay, from manage the family, their finance, yeah.
From the family perspective, all the way to businesses.
Okay.
Because at the end of the day, if you don't create that basis of manage your finances, no matter what you do, it's gonna have a negative impact on what you're trying to create on the other side. Because we are very good in creating money, in earning money. Now the question is, do we keep it?
Oh, I'm glad you mentioned that. And that's why it's very important. For example, you probably experienced this, or in terms of consumer people, a lot of people get into debt, right? I suppose it comes down to not managing money, you know, all your priorities when it comes to money and so forth, right? I mean, do you work with people who are in debt? Yeah, do you work with people who are in debt?
Yes, I do work with people actually both sides, before they get into debt and even after they get into debt.
Yeah.
If before we teach them techniques that they should use, so therefore the amount of money that, you know, they earn, they don't squander that, let's put it that way.
Yeah.
Okay, so we give them a technique we call 80-20. So if you make £100, make sure the maximum your living expense is £80. Mm. And the £20 is left there for investment, 10% of that, or £10. And the other £10 is for emergency cash.
Right.
Because somebody died, because somebody became sick and so on.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you go within that framework, there's no way you're going to be in debt.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest trouble we have most of the time is that we spend more, even without thinking of what we earn. So, okay, I had a pay rise from £100 to £150 now. Now I'm going on a spending spree. So I spent £180.
Mm-hmm.
Now bank is not there to help me.
Mm-hmm.
Because today the £30 become 35 tomorrow,
okay.
40, and then obviously I keep doing that and this is, now, this is one. The other is that we know how to help people in debt in order to reduce the amount of money that they owe.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we allow them or we work with them in terms of getting the, what do you call it, a write-off. You know, we can help them with a good reason, to write off up to 75% of the money that they owe.
Okay.
But honestly, I don't like it to be a habit.
Right.
Because I've got people that we help writing off for 75%. 2 years later, they're in debt again.
So
we need to become a bit more disciplined with the money.
Yeah.
And we need to know what money is for.
Yeah.
Because money is not just to spend.
When you say, I wanted to do a whole series about the whole thing about business and finance, so I'm glad that you're here. But when you say that, we need to be more disciplined. What is it about when we're undisciplined? What do you say is the root problem when it comes to money? We're very looseful when it comes to money. I mean, a typical example would be, right, it's a fact that those who've won the lottery, right, within 4 or 5 years, they become broke. Because in their mindset, it's about spend. Got the money I want to spend. So, what is it about us that we're undisciplined when it comes to money?
Yeah, there are many reasons for that. One is the spending. So, I am who I am.
Mm.
I see, for instance, somebody like Lionel Richie or or like Jay-Z spending big time, and I want to compete with
them.
I have to go and buy all the branded thing, all the good thing, and thing, without looking into my, where are my bases. Yes. This is that indiscipline. If we don't change it, I mean, because we are passing it on to our children as well.
True, yeah.
All
yeah.
our children want us to wear branded thing. How? If my earning per month, let's say, is £2,500, how I'm gonna take 10% of that to buy a pair of trainers or trousers to my son?
Mm.
Worse than that, I may have two or three sons.
Mm.
So then it becomes what, 30%, 40%, so I can't afford that.
Mm.
This is the first thing. The second thing that we need to be very mindful of is that, what is the money is for?
Yeah.
The third thing is, we, most of us, particularly professional, we live 1 month away from bankruptcy. What does that mean is that, as long as I'm healthy, I can work, I've got my paycheck.
Mm.
But if I become sick, on the third month, the income is not coming anymore, I'm in trouble.
Yeah.
I made no saving.
Yeah.
I done nothing about that. I didn't teach my children to be disciplined themselves.
Right.
As a result of that, I lost my job, or I became sick, for whatever reason, I'm in trouble.
Yeah.
So majority of us, the biggest problem we have is that when we lose a job, or when we become sick, or a family member becomes sick, and then we have to treat them from off work. That discipline is something that we have to lock in. Okay. If we don't do that, we're in trouble.
Okay. I want to just come to your background, because where are you? Where were you born? Where did you come?
Yes, I was born in a country called Sao Tome is a tiny island in a 1 hour plane from Nigeria, from Lagos in Nigeria.
Lagos, yeah.
It's the only country in the world which Greenwich Meridian and Equator cross line.
Mm.
The only.
Mm.
And it's there in that dot.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very tiny country, 150,000 people. But the thing, I've born as Portuguese, and you know, obviously my dad is from Angola and all of those stories.
Okay.
And then, you know, I've been living in the UK now for 29 years.
29 years.
Yes, 29 years. I came to university, but then decided not to go back.
Okay.
It's a different story.
Okay.
So this is where I come from.
And you're married and family and all that. Yeah?
Yes. I'm married. I've got 3 children. One grown up. My daughter, my elder daughter, she just finished university and decided to become a cake designer. I don't know what does that mean anyway, but she loves it. The business is doing well, so okay. And then I've got 2 younger ones, 9 and 11,
mm.
a boy and a girl.
Mm.
So this is where it is, yeah.
Okay, then, that's good. Yeah. So now he's a serious family man.
Yeah.
And your little ones, they really, you're training them to be accountants, or you're doing business with you, or whatever?
Well, because maybe I'm fortunate enough to have a job I have,
yeah.
All my children, by time they were born, I create what we, for instance, education planning for them, insurance for them, all of those things. So they are, for argument's sake, God forbid if I die today, my kids are done. I mean, they've got a solution. Because even if I become sick, my children don't need my brother to feed them at all. And this is something that I would like, I'm very passionate about, and I think all of us should do it.
Okay.
We should always think, if things don't go right, how I've got a backup.
I'm glad you mentioned that, because it kind of leads on to the next question I'm going to ask you. Because one, like I said, one of the things we want to do is talk about, well, educate our community, the whole thing about finance and money and set your managing money and so forth, right? Do yourself do lectures or on that subject, or people come to you? How does it work with you?
Well, as a financial advisor, I've got a practice, obviously. People come to me, and you know, people are aware. Many of them come because they've got that problem, and then they want a solution.
Yeah.
Anyway, but this is the this is the beauty of it. But I also run loads of workshops, seminars and things, teaching people, you know, how they should they should look into finance.
Mm.
Because finance can be your best friend, but it can be also your best enemy.
Mm.
If you don't look after it. So at the end of the day, I'm very passionate about that. You're sitting down, we run seminars, we run workshops, teaching people. And I work with a lot of young people. I mean, you know, the young adults, I work with a lot, because they are the base of us.
Mm.
Once we have gone, they the ones replacing us. And if that discipline is not there, we're going to become what I call, you know, spenders all the time, and we're going to be serving other people all the time. And we have to stop that.
You see, you said something very profound, you know. You know, finance could be your best friend, your best enemy, you know, and it depends on the relationship you have. It's no different than we look at relationship, you know, because I look at relationship, you should look at relationship, to me, relationship as a business, you know, definitely as a business. And for example, for me, then to to invest into a restaurant, we'll do our research, we'll do our homework, you know what I mean? And then we said to ourselves, well, this is how much returns you want to get in the next 5, 10, 15 years. If it's not happening there, you need to reevaluate what you're doing, you know? So the kind of mindset you have in business, same kind of mindset you have in relationship, because it took me all ties in as one. And like you said, right, you know, finance could be your best friend, or it could be your worst enemy, it could be your nightmare. So I'm glad to see you bring all that together, because, you know, it's very important that we understand what's going on and so forth. What I want to do now is, if people can contact you in terms of email address or website, just let people know, and contact and so forth.
Yeah, I mean, people, I'm you know, quite very accessible anyway, and most people, honestly, I do give them a lot of for free, because it's something I'm passionate about. Mm. Just to pick up a bit on what you mentioned, is that we need also to acknowledge that the majority of separation, divorce in our community is due to finance mismanagement.
See.
We needed to tackle this issue, because we're destroying family, we're destroying community, we're destroying ourselves.
Yeah.
I mean, for one simple thing that we should take base off. Now, if somebody wants to contact me, I mean, I'm on a mobile, obviously. Can I say the number?
Yeah.
It's 07961 071 371 322 07961 071 322. By email, they can email me on JBS@Cybank, S for sure, sugar, ibank.co.uk. So JBS@Cybank.co.uk. And I am also on LinkedIn. I am
social media as well.
So please come back, and you know, if anything, ask the question, and then at least you know.
If we
can help you, I would be more than happy to help.
Because we will gather back here to talk about a bit more about the finance. Also relate to the whole thing about relationships as well, and so forth. You know, but I think it's very important that we understand it all ties in as one, right? One question I want to ask you as well, right? You come to the whole thing about finance, right, and money and so forth, right? And I remember earlier on you said that that for example, if you earn £100, make it more simple, right? That you put £20 away, right? £10 for emergency fund, and £10 for savings or whatever. And that comes down to self-discipline. And because I remember this sister called Dr. Sandra Hurst, she said that, you know, we should have several saving plans, so to speak, right?
Pot,
that's right. One for to have fun, right? One for your education, one for, like, say, a rainy day, right? And one for, you know, for bills or whatever the case may be, right? And she said that if you get a habit of doing that, right, it conditions the mind, you see what I'm saying? Because when it comes to money, it's how we condition ourselves and how we discipline ourselves. And like I said before, it's about conditioning, because one of the things is that with me, when it comes to money, I say money, I'm just uses it. And it's where I've been conditioned as well, because from young, you've been taught and been fed that money doesn't grow on a tree, money's the root of all evil. So when you got money, you say, whoa, you got to spend it, get out, you know what I'm saying? In your crazy subconscious mind, you know? So when you talk about your thing about discipline, right, I think it's the key. And, cause, you know, it's all about getting that subconscious mind clicked in. Now, could we condition, you know? Yeah.
You can condition it, and I think it's very easy to do, because if you've got a child, just give him 3 piggy banks or 4 piggy banks or 4 small little pots. Yeah. It's very easy to do. No one can tell me that they cannot go to a market and buy 4 small little piggy banks. And write on it there, this is for your birthday bash. This is for your bike. This is for your weekend, whatever. Just call it whatever name you want it, small little thing. And then every week you give him pocket money.
Yeah.
John, I'm giving you £5.
Yeah.
Remember, £1 for your birthday thing, £1 for this, £1 for this.
Mm.
In the beginning, the child is going to resist because he wants to have more sweeties than anything else.
Yeah.
Next week, you come again, £1 for your weekend, £1 for this, and £1 for this. Have you done it? I'm watching you. The other week, you do it. Before you know it, the child comes here, oh, dad, come, please. Give me the money to put on with this because my birthday, I'm going to bring all my friends.
Yeah.
So give the child something to look up to.
Yeah.
Not to go to the shop and just buy sweetie. And as long as you said mindset, the child can become conditioned. Oh, yeah, I want my birthday. I want all my friends here. My dad told me I need to make some saving. So he's got on an aim. You know, something if, which is of his interest. Not buying shit for him. My best, oh no, I want to go on, I want my bike, that BMX bike that I want. This is what that money is there for. So, if you create that,
yes,
you would be surprised by the time the child is 8, 9, 10,
yes.
The child becomes, oh, I need to.
Yeah. So,
now, this is the first point. The second point that you mentioned, that there is education fund and whatever, whatever. Think about the £100. £80 is your living expenses. And first point number one, you had a pay rise from 100 to 150. How much is it? 50% increase, right? Don't increase your expenditure from 80 to 150. Do the 50% again. So you increase it to 30%. And once you've done that, immediately you are conditioned yourself to live within your limit. And that £10 that you are separating as a long-term investment is the one who's going to be £3 of it is going to go for your child education. £3 of it is going to go for your old age. £3 of it is going to go for your whatever, for your home. And £1 of it is for you to enjoy yourself.
Okay.
Before you know that, it's done.
Okay. We've got about 3 minutes left.
Yeah.
Right. And boy, you have some wisdom, man. You know what I mean? And we definitely have to get you back here and talk about the whole thing about money, because we want to get this to our people, you know? Okay then. So what I want to do now is, if you don't mind, just give me your details again.
Yeah.
Right. And then we definitely want to bring you back in again and talk about the other thing about. We've got the money man. You know what I mean?
The
money wisdom man. Alright. Give us your details again, for Mr. Brother.
Yeah. Joe Santiago. 07961-071-322. Or you know, JBS at sibank.co.uk. JBS at Joe. If you want to find me, go to Facebook, I am there as One Pension, or LinkedIn as a Santiago with one, not I, in there. So you can find me. Or you can do 0203-289-9196.
Okay, fantastic. Okay, so inside the house again, we had Josie, who's given some information, the whole thing about finance, how we manage our money, and hit it from the mindset, because, you know, we've been conditioned poorly when it comes to our money. So Josie,
thank you very much. Thank you for having me, and thank you everybody to listen, because at the end of the day, if we can bring value, I'm more than happy to do that.
Thank
Please
you.
Ask questions.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.